Hey everyone, this is Christy here with Go See Christy Beauty Boutique, and we've been doing a series of videos on acne, and we actually have a playlist that we're focusing on acne hacks. So today we're going to be talking about nuts and acne. So when some people eat certain types of foods, they notice that they get a trigger, an acne trigger. So one of the most common nuts that people eat in America is the peanut, and it's actually not a nut, it's actually a legume. Here are some of the nuts, the actual nuts that can trigger acne. And again, it's not for everybody, but for those of you who find that nuts trigger acne, you may want to avoid eating are almonds, Brazil nuts, cashews, hazelnuts, macadamia nuts, and walnuts. So walnuts has 3 times the omega-3, which is the good fatty acid, but it has 6 times the bad fatty acid, which is omega-6. So you may want to balance that out. And later in the video, we're also going to be explaining how you can still eat nuts and how to neutralize the effects that it can have on acne triggers. So here are some foods that are common acne triggers for some people. The first one, as we talked about, is nuts. The other one is some seafood, as well as sugar, soy, wheat, processed foods, and dairy. So the most common question that I get, especially from someone who suffers from acne, is what foods causes acne? So it's not the actual food that directly causes the acne. It's how the food affects the hormones, which the hormones affect the sebum production, how much sebum, how thick the sebum is that can clog the pores. And so for every individual, it is different. So hormones affect every part of our body, and they're very important in our day-to-day bodily functions as well as our appearance. So for example, hormones affect our weight gain, weight loss, how thin or thick our skin is, how thick or thin the sebum that we make is, how much sebum do we make, hair growth, hair loss, muscle growth, muscle loss. So as you can see, it's not the food, but how the food interacts with our hormones, and the hormones affect how much oil that we make and how quickly our skin cell turnover rate is. So the typical American diet is overloaded with omega-6 fatty acids, which is the bad fatty acids, and we really need to eat a whole lot more of omega-3 rich fatty acids. Now, when you eat a diet that is richer of omega-3 diets, you will find that your body will respond less to those acne triggers because it neutralizes the effects of that. And so what studies have shown is that when you eat a diet that is high in omega-6 and fats, it actually affects the androgen, which is the male hormone. And so what it does for girls is it increases an earlier onset of puberty. And so the earlier the onset is of puberty, the more likely they are to experience a little bit later in life severe acne. And for both men and for women, androgen levels increase the amount of oil they produce as far as how thick the sebum is, which then can clog the pores. So typically when people have severe acne, their desquamation rate, which is the skin cell turnover rate, is a whole lot slower. So I don't need to tell you a whole array of diseases of eating a regular diet that's rich in omega-6s. So some of the more common autoimmune diseases that are related to this is arthritis, psoriasis, eczema, and acne. If you have a diet that's rich in fats, then we all know about the common diseases such as cardiovascular disease, high blood pressure, and high cholesterol. So what do you do to neutralize the effects not only of acne, but later in life, a lot of the autoimmune diseases that a lot of people are getting? So if you eat a diet rich in omega-3, so here are some of the foods. So I hate to say this, but for those of you who don't like the taste of fish, you may want to take a supplement that has the omega-3 fish oil. But for those of you who love salmon, tuna, white fish, spinach, kale, egg yolks, you are in luck, as well as hemp seeds and flax seeds. So those are very high in omega-3s. So speaking of seafood, there are three types of people, I guess you would say, that have no known history ever of acne. So the first one is the rural villages of Japan. The second one is the Aceh tribe in eastern Paraguay and the Catavan Islanders of Papua New Guinea. So their diet is primarily plant-based. Little to no, I think they don't eat any processed foods, and very, very, very low in animal protein consumption. So they have no known documentation of acne ever. So if you eat, if you want to eat the foods that you love, but they tend to cause acne triggers for you, then how you can kind of neutralize that is eat a regular diet of omega-3 foods. So when you do eat an omega-6, it's not causing a flood of inflammation throughout your body. Okay, so stay tuned for our next upcoming video. We would once again love for you to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you know when it's up, and that will be on diet and acne and just some of the even more of common acne triggers and how you can neutralize those and avoid some of those as well. So thanks for watching, and why don't you comment below and let us know if there's any foods that we didn't mention that you tend to break out in. So for example, I have a client that notices that every time she eats Chinese food, she tends to break out. And it could be the cashews in the Chinese food or the processed sauces that they're used in Chinese food. I'm not really sure. So comment below and let us know. And thanks for watching.